Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Do We Know Them? I'm Lily Marston here with Jesse Smiles. And you guys, we have a lot going on.
We do. Today has been a journey.
Oh, by the way, it's episode 157.
Yes, we can't forget that. I know it's jarring to see me with headphones. I think there may have been one episode that I wore headphones for before, but it has honestly never happened because I don't like to listen to myself while we film. If you're wondering why Lily has two headphones always, it's because one is to listen to herself, the other is to talk to me. I usually just have like an AirPod or a Beats or whatever the fuck, so you don't really see it, but that's how I listen to Lily while we're filming. Anyway, long story short, we got gifted a bunch of audio. If you saw our last episode, we talked about the possibility of that happening and that someone had reached out to us, but we finally got the new equipment and I'm just terrified that it'll go horribly. So I'm wearing headphones to just like listen to everything because there's so many settings.
I was going to say it's super cool and I feel like it's going to be great and hopefully it sounds good right now, but there's a learning curve. We're not audio experts.
No, we're not.
Also, before we get any further, can we address my face?
Oh, yeah.
I may have gotten a root canal earlier today. First of all, I didn't know. I had a couple appointments coming up and I didn't know if it was going to be my cleaning or if it was going to be the root canal. And it ended up being the root canal. And it turns out when they numb your root, your face stays numb for a long time. And you'll notice that half of my face is kind of just drooping. We pushed this even like an hour or two past when we were going to film, and it's now 5. And I finished my appointment at 1.
Yeah.
And still face is drooping. So don't make fun of me.
When you showed me earlier, it did look quite concerning, but I think it's gotten better since then.
I was trying to FaceTime you so you could see what we're dealing with. It's a little noticeable, you can say. I feel like I'll check in like an hour and see if I just took. No, it's pretty noticeable. But hopefully it'll be gone in a couple hours. I think it will be. So, anyway, bye.
It's gotten a little better, but it's still pretty. It's just kind of like when I smile, like
yeah,
basically
smile,
that
don't
entire
smile.
Side
it,
is just.
You gotta just keep it shut. You'll probably not be numb by the end of the episode, and then it'll be fine. But it's just for a little bit.
The problem is that like when I like smile or with like a closed mouth smile, and like when I smirk in general, I feel like my mouth curves down, and now it's just curving like really down. So I look like I'm like have a very pronounced like cartoon level frowny face.
Yeah. Anyway. But anyway, so. So yeah, we have a lot of changes this episode, but we're going to try to make it through. And if there are any audio blips, if you will, now you
don't
know
say
why.
Anything.
So yeah. And if it sounds amazing, tell us. Thank you. We love that.
Yeah. By the way, the equipment we got is from a company called Mackie, which like as audio non-experts, we didn't know what that was. Turns out they're like really
big. And yeah. I told my stepdad, I was like, it's some brand named Mackie. I think they're like a small business. And he was like, bitch, you're dumb. He's like, no, they're huge. I was like, oh, okay, period. But they gave us so much. It was so generous. What we're on right now is a DLZ creator. Lily will throw up a picture here. In comparison to this, which is what we used to film on, which looks like a Walkman from the 90s. And not much, you know, like versatility here. You put the volume and you record. That's it.
This, it's like touch screen. Yeah. It's like, first of all, it's like bigger than a laptop. Like, it's like huge.
Right? It's an iPad size, at least just the touchscreen part. And then you have
the rest. I was going to say, but you have a big iPad.
No, just the touchscreen part.
Yeah, no, it's huge. And we're still learning how to use it completely, but it's so cool. And I am very excited about it.
Yeah, we're thrilled. Also, these headphones are from them and we're just so grateful. So thank you, Robert Mackey, and his fiance who watches. Girlie, we love you and you slay very hard. And thank you for introducing your fiance to us. Okay,
thanks.
Let's continue on or start. We didn't start, so we can't continue when there was nothing before. So these topics are lighthearted. So just buckle in, get some popcorn. What else can you get? Some sun chips.
A beverage,
pizza.
Do some gardening.
Yeah. Do whatever you gotta do, okay, girly? That's none of our business. And we're gonna walk you through these two dramas because the first one, I have to admit, I've seen the first TikTok that we're gonna react to, but I saw zero of the follow-up and apparently it got pretty fucking wild. So we'll just start with that, I guess, which is the Instacart thief. Have you heard
and
anything
I know
about this?
It, as usual. Oh,
okay.
No.
Okay. This is all surrounding someone named Hannah and someone named Michaela. Hannah is the customer, okay? And then Michaela is the Instacart person.
Do you use Instacart?
That's the one that does groceries, right? I have used it before, not anymore.
Yeah, like I get my Publix from there. So it's like a grocery store. And then they tell you exactly when they're shopping each item. I like it, honestly. I think it's great. And they do overcharge a little bit for each item, I think. But it's not horrible. I think Postmates does worse.
I would say, honestly, that was never my concern with using it. It was that I would order something and then they would tell me that they didn't have it. And I'd be like, are you sure? Because I feel like they do. Because they tell you, like, when they're shopping, they're like, oh, really? What do you want instead? I'm trying to think of an example because it would be something, like, so basic that I'm like, they have to have, like, come on. Like, they don't not have any, like, no brands. No.
Was it a man shopping?
Always.
Okay, so that's the issue. If it's a man shopping, I know my shit's going to get fucked up. No offense, but it's just facts and scientific proof. They mess up everything, and it's always like, you want gummy bears, they're going to like substitute it with trash bags. You're like, hello, sir, are you in the same world as me?
A lot of the times it was that they would tell me they didn't have it. I'm like, they definitely do. You're lying. But like, fine, whatever. It would be like, they don't have vanilla ice cream or something. And I'd be like, sounds made up. But then the worst would be stuff that I would be ordering for like making something, like an ingredient. I mean, this isn't an example that fits that, but like you said, gummy bears, but they would bring you gum and it'd be like,
oh, that's diabolical.
That's not. Oh my God. What was it one time? I asked for like heavy whipping cream or something and they came back
They just brought you something heavy.
It was a kind of ice. It was a kind of ice cream that I wanted. And they came with coffee creamer that was like flavored similarly. And I'm like, what the fuck am I going to do with that?
You just have to start churning it. It's like, what the fuck?
I've honestly never had that experience like where they say it's not there at all. But when men do get my order, I get concerned because it is usually, it's not like huge mix-ups really, but they make mistakes, they make substitutions that don't make sense, and you know, it is what it is. Anyway, the reason we're here today is not because of a mix-up, okay? This was not someone that substituted something. This is way weirder. Okay, so we're gonna watch the original video that kicked this all off from Hannah.
Hi, if your name is Michaela and you're an Instacart driver, or you have a friend named Michaela who is an Instacart driver in Gulf Shores, Alabama, hey, this message, this video is for you, okay? I'm gonna give you some receipts. We'll just start out with the receipts. Michaela, here you are. This is Michaela.
Allegedly. Notably. Okay. I mean, that is Michaela, but she uses a lot of filters. So we have about 7 different Michaelas. I'm not even being dramatic.
Which looks like a different person in every...
Well, you be the judge.
Oh.
Like,
oh.
Name one of those that looked like the other, except the two that were filmed on the same day.
Yeah, no, is her face a completely different color as her body in that first one?
Yeah, I don't know. Also, she's a big fan of the bold glamour filter, which says a lot in my opinion.
When I put that on, oh my God, it's terrifying.
It literally makes me want to cry. You know who uses that a lot? That lesbian girl. What is her name? Literally, she's like, I just want to find a girl. Oh my God, you haven't seen her?
I know exactly who you're talking about. Yeah, that she always has her hands in her pockets.
Yeah, she like unironically uses a bold glamour filter and it's insane. Oh my God. Okay, anyway, continuing on, I just wanted to point out that is Michaela, but it's, you know, not really.
You're honestly really pretty, Michaela, and I really hope you're not planning right now. So you started shopping for my order and you found like literally everything, but most importantly, you found the pack and play, which is the reason we placed this order, because we have been on an 8-hour road trip with 2 toddlers and we forgot our pack and play at home. We need somewhere for my 1-year-old to sleep where she will be safe. So we got a pack and play and it says that you checked out, you got the pack and play, no other changes can be made. Then it says that you refunded the pack and play and that you were on the way and no other changes could be made. So I immediately messaged you. You told me that the box for the pack and play was too beat up and so you couldn't scan it. I told you that you could ask an employee for help and you're like, look, I can give you the receipts. I didn't steal anything. And I said, I'm not accusing you, okay? Then I get a notification that at 7:52, you delivered my order. And wouldn't you know it, we were pulling in our driveway at 8:00. So we should have passed each other. I pull in my driveway and I notice there's nothing on the driveway. There's no things here. And besides the pack and play, all of my order was stuff for my kids. Goggles for my kids, milk for my kids, food for my kids. Not one thing in there was for an adult. Every single thing in there was for a child. A sound machine so that my baby daughter can sleep. Not at my door. So what do you think I do? I immediately call Instacart. They tell me that they got in touch with you and you left it at a black and white building. I said, that's not good enough. I need you to have her come back and point to the house where she left it. So then they transfer me to the missing items people and they tell me that they actually can't get in touch with you. So now my beef is not only with Michaela, but it's also with Instacart. Because what do you mean you can't get in touch with her? She's your employee, right? She, like, right? You can't get in touch with her. So then they tell me, we'll give you a refund, but you're not going to get this refund for 5 to 7 business days. Y'all, we're on our first day of vacation. So I go into my app. I go to my Instacart app. My whole total order was $130. I can show you. Okay, $138. But why was my car charged $229? And actually, so it says that now, but actually earlier when I went and looked, and I wish I had screenshotted it, it was $290. So my bank account is actually $290 charged. So we are on our first day of our week-long vacation. We are out $300. $200 or $130 of that spent towards children's items that we now don't have that we have to go buy again, and we will not see that money back in our account until we're back home from vacation. So Michaela, you have my address. Could you please come over, give me my shit back if you took it, or me and you can go drive to the house where you did drop it off. We can knock, knock, and I can get my shit because I need my shit. I love her. Then you and I together can go to Instacart, get your ass a raise because they definitely were not happy with you on the phone. And then we can take my money back from them. Thank you and goodbye. Please help me find Michaela.
And everyone's like, we can't find her because she looks different in every fucking picture.
If she ever goes missing, she's in trouble.
Oh my God, wait. So I can totally understand that frustration.
Yes.
Even on a more of a level because I think I've told this story before because we talked about blowing up brands when you have followers and sending people to go attack them.
Yeah.
Which I did not do per se. I don't even remember what I had said. I wasn't like super specific about all of it, but I Airbnb, I booked a Coachella house and it charged me, and that's like, Coachella houses are fucking expensive. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And it was super last minute, so one, it was even more expensive, and two, it was like 2 days before we were supposed to go, and it says that it booked me this house, but plot twist, it didn't book it. It just charged me, and then they booked the house to someone else. So the owner of the house is like, sorry, no, I'm already booked. What are you talking about? And then they were like, oh, we're going to refund your money in like 5 to 7 days. And I was like, that's not going to help me because Coachella's in two. And I think, I don't know, I mean, I'm sure it was followers that ended up getting them to answer, but I was like literally like yelling at the people on the phone because I'm like, you just ruined my trip then. Like, I can't go because I don't have another $2,000 to put towards this fucking house. And you just are like, oh, sorry, it's going to be back in 7. What do you mean? And then eventually they gave me the credit to book a new one, but like most places aren't going to do that. And I do think it was because I had followers.
But anyway, jumping back to Hannah and her situation, that was the original situation. And this alone has 3.2 million likes, okay? People were on the case. They were going to find Michaela no matter how hard it was to find her because she looks nothing like her profile picture. So I saw this originally. It was way under a million. I think it was like, honestly, I want to say even under 100,000 like likes.
You're always first to the party.
I know. It's my For You page. What can I say? I'm gifted. Okay, so after she posted that, Michaela then responded, and this has since been deleted, but we have it.
Hi, if your name is Michaela and you're an Instacart driver or you have a friend named Michaela who...
Okay, so let's just jump right into this. Just woke up, so I don't really care about how I look, but according to everybody who messaged me anyways, I'm not even cute anyways, girl, so it don't matter. Okay, first things first. I have people telling me that your order was $290. I have your receipt right here because we are required to keep it. Let's see. I don't know if you can tell what's on there. Okay, so there's your Curology. Let's see. The little sound machine is right here as well. And it is $98.11 total. So for people to be messaging me, telling me to return the pack and play to you and to be threatening me and my kids is beyond me. But I will try to get this cleared up the best I can. I do know that you needed somewhere for your child to sleep, which is why I was apologizing. I never said I didn't steal. I have the receipt for proof. I said, here's your reassurance that because you had mentioned, well, it says you've already checked out and started delivering. So why no pack and play? Because the pack and play couldn't be scanned. Barcode was so scratched off, I couldn't scan it, as you said. So I wanted to reassure you that you were refunded the pack and play. Not that I stole. I wasn't worried about you thinking I stole.
Why wouldn't you just ask?
Literally.
That's not a thing.
Well, it may be a thing, but no, all that
it's
says
a thing
to
that
me,
you maybe can't scan it, but like, it's not a thing that you wouldn't just ask them and they would look it up in the system.
To me, all this says,
at
I'm
Target?
Sorry, like, I'm not trying to be like all entitled or whatever, But ask an employee for help. Obviously, if someone's ordering shit for their kids and I was shopping for them, I would know they need this shit for their kids. Let me make it happen. Like, people in Target would help them and be like, oh, let me just look up how much this is. And it would be no problem.
Yet Target, that's like the number one place I would feel like they would be able to resolve that very quickly.
Yes. Especially she has kids. Understand this woman's pissed because she has kids. She was on an 8-hour long road trip. Like, just take accountability and be like, hey, my bad. Like, I should have gotten that to you. But I really want to hear her explanation as to why I never showed up at the house. So let's keep watching.
And correct. It says that I was delivering the order to you around 752, 756. And I delivered to a blue and white house, which I will also post. I have people saying that it was a black and white house. Don't know where that's coming from. And I also contacted Instacart yesterday when you had said where's the order. It was delivered to the house that their GPS had taken me to, and I have proof from them saying that it was completed, which means that it was completed. I didn't keep the order.
What proof from who?
And I also have gotten messages saying that yours was, like I said, $290. If anything, I don't think it would be that much, but it could be a pre-authorization charge from where the pack and play and the puddle jumper was already on there that you were refunded for. But I am waiting the transcripts from Instacart for, you know, proof of everything, and I will come back. But to be having people messaging my family and myself with threats, and people say, well, why didn't you reply? Well, because it's 3 o'clock in the morning.
She didn't tell people to threaten.
And just says, you, I have children, and I didn't still, so I wasn't expecting to have to deal with backlash.
Okay, well, at least your children have a bed. But also, she says that it was confirmed that I dropped it off. Confirmed by who? She
literally, the only person that can confirm that is you and the person who was receiving it. Instacart can try to look at both ends and figure out what happened. But ultimately,
the most Instacart can do is look at the picture you took of it on the doorstep, but then you easily could have picked it up off the doorstep afterwards and left.
Absolutely. So I guess she didn't include the first picture of that delivery, but I do have it here and it's included now. We're going to watch Hannah's video right after Michaela's video. And this is the proof of delivery picture. Notably, what Hannah's about to point out, and I am going to have to agree with her on this one, is that the front porch is right here to the bottom right, and there's nothing on it.
Well, the picture is supposed to be of the items, not of the house.
Agreed.
This could have been just a drive-by. You snapped a pic and left.
Agreed. Yes, that is correct. I don't know how she thought that was hard-hitting evidence, but anyway, this is Hannah's update right after Michaela posted and quickly deleted what we just watched.
Good morning, everybody. I'm sure you have seen that Michaela has responded. If you didn't see her response, it's because she very quickly deleted it. But she did provide some proof. I will show you a screenshot. So she said that this is the house she dropped everything off at, but it's cropped here and you can tell that the car's like moving. Here's the porch with no items. There's no items here. And she said that she knocked on the door and nobody was home. This is not my house. She said she knocked on the door and nobody was home. And so she left the items and was uncomfortable with that. And so she took a picture of the house for like to be safe. I don't know. Well, we're out. We're getting coffee and breakfast and stuff. We're in the neighborhood. So we are going to go to that house and I'm going to knock on the door and get my stuff. If my stuff's there, then cool. My stuff is there. And I even said in that video that I hope she didn't take my things because she's very pretty. And at the end, I said, come with me. Let's go, girl. Let's go get my things. So let's see. Let's go look.
Peek-a-boo.
Okay, wait. This is developing as I'm making this video because I just got some screenshots from some Facebook posts she made. Okay, she's saying this is the house that we were told she was told to hand it to.
She was posting on Facebook too? What the fuck? What is this? Okay, so I guess she did post on Facebook too. I don't know where this is, what this is, but it's a comment from her saying, this is the fucking house it took me to all the way out in Kiva Dunes. And that's where we get this photo. And then she says, we have to post proof. And then someone said, there's no packages in that picture. And she says, order was directly handed to someone.
Oh, so now we have a third party involved.
Yeah, that's not my house. Again, that's not my house. And that order was directed to hand to the customer and there's no packages, right? Okay. In the video, the response video, she said that nobody was home, so she left on the porch.
Yep.
But then here,
shut the fuck up.
She's saying that we were home. We were home because that's not my house, so we'll go knock on that door.
Then where's the house?
We found it.
Oh my gosh, she's at the house.
Oh, and there's cameras, so we can just get them to
shut
the cameras.
Up. This is fun. I like this one.
I know, right?
Nobody's here. Which it doesn't look like anybody's. He's here. Nobody's been here.
You see if there's a car down here?
There's no cars. Yeah, like nobody's here. Okay, so we are back home. There was nobody at that house, and it looked like there hadn't been anybody at that house because the grass hadn't been cut, and the trash bin was out at the road, which a lot of owners will do when they leave. I don't know. She's telling me she's at the police department right now because people are pulling in and out of her driveway and threatening her children. Y'all, stop doing that. Stop doing that. I don't condone that behavior. Stop doing that. I just wanted my stuff back, and I still do want my stuff. But it is incredibly strange that she said she took a picture of that house. There's nothing on the porch. I just went to the house. Nobody's home. Like not even nobody's home. Like, maybe they went out for breakfast. Like, it doesn't look like anybody's been home. Did notify the guard about everything. So maybe if this stuff shows up, it shows up. We shall see how this continues to develop.
Also, I think it's interesting that she also mentioned at one point that she has kids.
Oh, absolutely. I was like, girl, if you're going to mention that you do have kids, maybe provide a little bit more proof, because now it absolutely looks like you stole it, because who else could use a pack and play and some puddle jumpers and goggles in the summer than a fucking parent?
Also, wait, though, did she just say, though, that she was going to ask the guard, is this like a gated community?
I don't think that was gated. It looked pretty open, like one of those beach towns.
Well, because she was in a golf cart, though.
Yeah, that's true. Some of them have that entrance that's gated, maybe. And then she was just like in that community.
Yeah, because then you definitely have evidence of whether she, I mean, I guess she did come in.
Yeah, but also that would make more sense why she stole it, because I feel like people would steal from someone they think is wealthy or on vacation, or, you know, they assume a lot of things. So all of this happened. We can't really confirm the timeline too well, because like we said, we do have like her deleted videos, but we don't know when or like what day they were posted. So this message that I'm going to show is like literally her proof that this order was delivered, which like we said, can't happen. And first of all, this is definitely a robot she's chatting with in Instacart, in my opinion. It says, please do not worry. I have added the note for you with the proof of the chat, and make sure that the team will be taking the right steps against the team.
Team against the team.
Sounds legit. Okay. And then this is allegedly Michaela answering back, saying, can you confirm the order was delivered so that I can at least screenshot that for proof? I need some sort of proof for the police department. To which this person responds, sure. The order for the customer has been completed about 10 hours ago. And she's like, screenshot, you see, guys, I fucking delivered it. Told you, idiots.
Literally, Amazon takes pictures of it at the door. Like,
yeah, you see them, step back, make sure it's not blurry. You see, and if you go out to get the package while they're doing it, like, you will be in that picture. You're supposed to take a picture on that doorstep. Like, that is well known.
Because even I had one recently. There's like, I live somewhere where it's like different entrances. So, but it's the same address. So a lot of my stuff gets brought to my neighbor. I got a picture from Amazon one time, and I like looked, and it was like, that looks like my house, but that's not my doormat. Figured out where it was. Mission accomplished. Mm-hmm. You don't take a drive by leaving the house.
Okay, so I'm reposting the video because apparently it didn't load correctly. It didn't load all the little pictures and shit. So this is
she's like, I'm reposting this because I forgot to turn on the bold glamour filter in the last one. And now I figured it out.
This is a response to Hannah as the Instacart thief. I don't even know where to start. Okay, so I have the receipt. Hang on. Here's your receipt.
We've seen that. Okay.
Oh, she's literally, this is her redoing it. Literally.
Yeah, I'm telling you.
Because she has the glamour filter.
I know.
Here's your receipt. If you look, there's all your, like, your Curology, the little yoga sleep sound machine, and like that's it, $98. Because I'm hearing that apparently your order was $290. Now, the only reason I can think that that would happen is the pre-authorization hold that happens right when you place the order for everything that was originally ordered, such as the pack and play that you have even stated.
Stop standing by that. I'm over it.
Because of the fact that I
had told you. That's such a weird HUD.
It was too damaged to even scan the barcode. And you had asked me, no pack and play. And that's when I had explained that to you. And he was like, well, it says you're already on the way. You're already delivering. Right. But it does say that the pack and play was canceled. So for people to be messaging me about returning a pack and play is beyond me.
She never said her order was $290. She explained quite clearly that it charged her more at the moment. Maybe she didn't know exactly why. But it sucks that you have $290 gone from your account. And you're not going to get it for 3 to 5 days. And you never got anything. Like that, you know what
I
mean?
It was like a mutual complaint about like Michaela not delivering her stuff, but also just Instacart being
shitty. Absolutely.
I'm about to show you where I have talked to support when I'm being told that I did not. I talked to them for 2 minutes at 8:20 last night.
Okay, so this is that screenshot that I just read. Definitely not a real person, or if it is a real person,
yeah,
they don't know much about Instacart, I'll just say.
I also have where they have confirmed that it was completed 10 hours ago at 6:29:24. This is the house on Kiva Way that it was delivered to. Because I'm also hearing that...
How do you fuck up the house?
I'm just literally flabbergasted
at how she can... Why is she not taking any accountability for like, oh, sorry, I didn't look at the address right. Like,
well, she says that's where the GPS led her. I'm like, did you match it with the numbers on the house?
For the number? Yeah. Like,
I mean, listen, I get it. Things happen. It could be overwhelming. A lot of people are doing multiple orders. It's fine. I understand that completely. But like, how can you still stand here and wag your little finger around the wrong house with no proof of delivery because there's nothing on the steps and just be like,
what do you mean she had the chat?
But anyway, so I just don't know where she gets the goal to be like, it's right here, idiots. Have you seen it? Like,
that's the thing. It's not even that she's just like, here, look. It's like, look how stupid you guys are.
What did she say? It's beyond me. Yeah, it's beyond me too, because I don't fucking see shit on that porch. And if there was, and she all of a sudden showed that she delivered it to a house, I would have been like, okay, it was just a misunderstanding. But this is bizarre.
Well, and then with the deleted video and saying that it was delivered, no one was there, but then you handed it to them. Okay. And
that apparently it was a black and white house.
Not that she's such a stank attitude. What?
But to have people messaging me threatening my children over an order that was delivered is absolutely insane to me. Because I didn't reply in time. I mean, it was 3:00 in the morning from what I'm hearing that all these people were even seeing it to get to me. And I was asleep like a normal person. I mean, I don't really know what else. Like, what kind of proof do I need? Because the order had said hand to customer, but there was no one home at this house. So I had to sit it outside. So there was no proof that I had to even take, but I decided to take a picture of the house anyways, just in case. For not only my safety, but yours. So, like...
What? I don't get it.
What? I don't know, girl. I'm not saying that you told everyone to message me by any means, because I know you didn't. But it's the fact that you made a post claiming I stole when I indeed did not.
No,
she like lets the camera go a little bit too much to the right. You see her kid in the pack and play. We're like, oh, I fucking knew it.
But also, like, she never said that she stole it. She was just like, let's figure out what happened.
Literally, she said, if you didn't steal it, then let's go together to the house of the person who has it and let's grab it. Like,
that you handed it to, supposedly.
That's the thing, too. If she had truly handed it directly to a resident, that would be so easy to prove. Like, if there was really someone there, you know the address you dropped it off at, you have a picture of the house, that is easy to prove. I will say, though, things do get pretty juicy. I mean, I feel like it's juicy already when she was showing up to the house. Like, my heart was pounding. Like, pounding? What's the word? Jesus.
Pounding.
Pounding. Fuck, that word just beat my ass. Okay, it turns out Hannah wasn't the reason that people found Michaela. Michaela's the reason that people found Michaela. So she, I guess that went viral. She said, Michaela from Alabama. People were trying to find her. People didn't find her, but Michaela, in this response that we're about to show, shows her Facebook. And then allegedly that's how people started finding her. And now she wants to pit it all on Hannah and be like, no, everyone found me. They're in my driveway. But it seems like she might have had something to do with that, or at the very least, definitely boosted. Like, hey, I'm Michaela. I'm over here, guys. Like, why do that?
Yeah, because I mean, I don't even know how people found her originally, if they did, because like you could, I mean, the best I would do would be like reverse image search
the profile picture,
but that's so small on Instagram that I don't think it would even work.
No, I don't think so.
That the only other thing would be like you literally look up the name Michaela and then are like looking for people that live in that area and someone that's similar.
This is how she allegedly self-doxed herself and then complained about it.
Let me just read this, since obviously you can't. It says, I have
also, by the way, she's replying to a comment here that said, wait, on Facebook post, you said you handed to customer directly and that she was home, which is obviously a contradiction to saying she wasn't home.
I've been told that I'm going viral on TikTok, apparently, for stealing an order from a girl named Hannah off of Shipt, since I've received plenty of messages saying Shipt. This is the house that Instacart, in all caps, took me to for delivery all the way down Fort Morgan Road. She claimed it was the wrong address 30 minutes after I left, in which I contacted Instacart. She knew she was refunded for the pack and play because they did not have it. That was the last one in stock.
If I hear that one more time.
And it was not on the receipt, which I still have, because we are required to keep the physical paper copy of the receipt. And then it just mentions that everyone is saying that it's a shipped order, and it is not. But nowhere in that does it say that it was handed directly to
in
her or that they were home.
Yeah, what is she talking about? Okay, so from this, people found her Facebook, and then
yes,
through
which she
in
prominently
the
displays.
Yeah, and also doesn't show the comments, curiously. But again, Hannah shows the comments, and they clearly say, LMAO, they were home. I handed it directly to a customer.
Yeah, like, unless someone Photoshopped those, which doubt it. interesting choice. And yeah, she mm-hmm. at this point, not, like, it's one thing to put your name and even your full name. It's another to do that with your profile picture. Do you know how easy it is to find people on Facebook?
Like, yeah. And then I can't. It's kind of like, I've had my Facebook since I think high school or like right after high school. I don't want to know all the information that's on there that people can access, because I'm pretty sure I put way too much, you know, like before I realized
I've privated a lot of pictures, but yeah.
Like, I'm just like, I don't know, jobs. I mean, people put everything, relationship statuses, birthdays,
I mean,
everything.
Honestly, speaking as an FBI agent, everything I find is always through things that, like, they definitely don't realize are public. So,
oh,
like,
100%.
Yeah. Friends are the biggest thing. Like, you can find family members, you can find, like, everyone
through
you find through
friends
and what they've liked, what they've checked into. Yeah. Like, there's a lot of stuff you don't realize. So, someone says, why not just show proof that you communicated with her, screenshot? Shots or screen recordings or things. This can literally be over and forgotten about by just showing the proof that you were in contact with her. So she uploads screenshots of the conversation. This looks like it was TikTok messages.
Oh, does it?
So Michaela, it's cut off. It says, with my card in all caps.
Sorry.
But to have people thinking I stole to the point they are saying I don't need to be in my own home is beyond me. What? My kids are in danger because of a pack and play that wasn't even bought to begin with. We know.
Yeah, we got it. You couldn't scan
you
it.
Didn't want
you
to
didn't want to ask an
you
employee.
Didn't want to ask for help. But if there was any way to prove that I did not take anything more than I've already provided, I'd give it to you. I swear on my life I would. And Hannah says, why should we go to Target and buy more if you dropped it off? Like,
because I think that what she's suggesting, I just want to say really quick, is for some reason she's suggesting, let's go to Target, I'll buy you the pack and play, I think is what
oh
I'm
that's
gathering.
What she said, she'll put it on her card
with her, like, card. Yeah, like, she's like, I'll buy it.
Why?
She's like, well,
no,
why do
you
we
wouldn't
need to buy
offer
more?
That like if
yeah,
you didn't
like,
think that you had fault in this, like,
it just shows up at Hannah's doorstep.
big bow on it.
Yeah, that doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, why would we go to Target and buy more if you dropped it off? Like, question mark. I don't think you understand the definition of slander. I'm not responsible for the conclusions other people draw in the comments. I said in my video that either you did or didn't take my stuff.
Oh my God, somebody
right
send
to
that to
speech.
Janet, I beg.
I have the right to free speech, and I never disclosed anything other than information that is already readily available on your Instacart profile.
Oh my God, preach, bitch. You're speaking straight to my heart.
Right? And then she says, no, you something.
No, you posted accusing me, girl, I think is
thank
what
you.
That says.
Yeah. No, you posted accusing me, girl, and let's see if she scrolls.
Right here, I've talked to her about going to Target and replacing her stuff with my card.
Just read it.
Since she claims she cannot
stop
find
the pointing.
It, in which she tells me that why would we go to Target and buy the items if I've dropped it off? So.
And
your response? Really?
That's it. In her response, it says it's cut off. It goes, and we would go get it because that's, and then we don't know.
Oh,
it's a mystery.
I guess we'll never find out. The way she just giggles, and we're all waiting for her to continue speaking.
Okay, wait. So then Hannah posts more updates.
Oh God.
She goes to Target.
I mean, yeah, she needs her shit.
Okay, hopefully this is the final update for you guys because I really want to enjoy my family vacation. First and foremost, we did go to Target today to get all the items that we didn't get delivered to us. And wouldn't you know it, two pack and plays, these are the ones that I ordered. There's two, and then there was two more of another brand, and then two more up here. So if there was truly one, like something wrong, she could have easily replaced that. I don't really know how it works with Instacart as a shopper, but maybe she scanned it so that Target employees saw that it looked like it scanned and then went on the app and refunded it, but kept it in her cart and took it that way. I don't know. last night when she's saying that she delivered it to that house, that was within like 10 minutes of my delivery notification that I noticed it was not there. So we immediately got in the golf cart and drove all around the neighborhood, knocking on doors, looking on every single porch. It's not a very large neighborhood. Y'all, my stuff was not here. Like, my stuff is not in this neighborhood. I posted in our neighborhood page. Nobody got our items. The house she's saying she delivered to, nobody's there. Nobody is living there right now. So if she had left it on that porch, it would still be there right now, or it would have been there within 10 minutes of me seeing it last night. When I say it, I mean the notification that my items were delivered. So she's been in my DMs this morning telling me she wants to make things right. And I said, just tell me where my stuff is. And she said that she already did. And I said that my things are not there. So then she told me that she was filing a police report against me because harassment. I'm not condoning anybody to harass anyone. I literally just wanted to find her to get...
Maybe she should file one for theft!
Like- I'm telling you right now, she is not actually doing that. Like, she is 100% bullshitting, bluffing. Sure. Yeah. And especially, she's like, let's go to Target, I'll buy it for you. Oh, you don't believe me? I'm going to the police department! Like, it just is very...
No, I don't...
Strange bullshit. Course of action, I'll say.
She has leaked my neighborhood name and my street name, and then in one video where she was leaking stuff, TikTok actually took the video down for a breach of privacy. She's been asking me for my phone number so that she can call me, and she did ask for a WhatsApp. I don't have that, but I ended up having to block her because it was getting nowhere. I was telling her the only way to make it right is to just tell me where my things were, and she kept telling me it was at that house. It's not at that house. Nobody's at that house. It would still be sitting on that porch. This will end on a happy note, though, because we can all give a round of applause to Shipt, Instacart's competitor, because while Instacart has been completely silent this whole time, Shipt actually emailed me and they're sending us a pack and play. So they are the true hero here. For Michaela saying,
team.
I think she said that she's like not going to press charges against me. I don't know what you would press charges against me for, because I don't,
she's
I'm
just
not
gonna
slandering,
press them,
okay? I'm not defaming. Like, there's no defamation here. I can come on this app and I have the right to free speech. And
absolutely.
I even said in my first video, second, third, if you have my stuff, just give it to me. If you don't, just show me where it's at. It's that simple. I'm not calling you names. I'm not calling you a thief. I'm not doing any of that.
I will. No, I'm just kidding.
I can press charges for theft. So, yeah. But I won't, because I am on vacation and I want to enjoy my vacation. So hopefully this is the last update I give, because I truly want to just put my phone down and just enjoy this. And now I have a safe place for my daughter to sleep. We went to Target this morning. Even though it put us double out of money, at least we will get a refund when we get back home, and hopefully by then everything has calmed down.
Oh my god. Shipt, honestly, I have tried it once. It was a lot better than Instacart. It just is a little bit pricier for sure. Yeah, they do like a lot of stores that Instacart doesn't do, but I think particularly I used it for Target when Instacart didn't even have Target on their system yet, and it was great. But what the fuck is up with brands in 2024 that you don't understand that if a situation like this is happening, send her 17 pack and plays. It's got millions
literally
of views.
It's
like,
so
what
easy.
Are you doing?
It is nothing for you, and it will be such good PR.
But it says a lot that their customer service team, that actually, I have to comment on that for a second. That's really concerning that the team that the people can reach out to that work for that company are either bots or people that are completely unaware of what the fuck is going on. And they're also seemingly completely unable to solve the situation. That is really concerning, because how the fuck, if something goes wrong on Instacart, if the person who did the shopping can't even reach them, how the fuck are we as the consumer supposed to reach them?
Well, and when you think about it, like, the way, I mean, I'm not saying that they like don't have any employees, but like, wouldn't their most of like their infrastructure of their company, besides like building the app, be fucking customer service?
Oh, you would be so surprised. First of all, they require people to know basically the bare minimum of like, this is what the company does, and just be there. Be a person that, like, if something needs to be escalated, I guess you can make that happen. And that is problematic as fuck, because people are not calling customer service. I mean, some people do. They call customer service for funsies and to hear themselves talk. Believe me, when I worked in retail, it's quite clear that some people are just like entitled bastards who like think that,
yeah, and like
everybody else
for something.
Something
like Instacart, with like we were saying in the beginning, like I've had so many issues with like wrong things. Like, I'm sure they
yes.
do get a lot, but there should be someone to escalate it to.
I will say, like with Postmates, for instance, Postmates, I don't know how they're like in person or like over the phone customer services, but that's only because it's never gotten to that point.
They just refund your money.
Yeah, literally. I take a picture, I give a brief description. I'm like, this. I love when the order's like missing something. They're like, take a photo. I'm like, okay.
just your hand.
No, but that always solves a problem. And they're just like, okay, here's your money. It'll be in your account in 2 days. That I understand. Like, make a better automated system if you cannot have a better in-person customer service, because this seems completely fucking insane.
And I feel like, especially when you bring up Postmates, because they do, like, they'll immediately credit your account so you can buy it again.
Oh, yeah.
That's because they don't have much overhead, because, like I just said, like, wouldn't all of their money basically go to, like, building the app and then having customer service?
Yeah. What else?
And then obviously paying the drivers, but they get a percentage of the stuff. So it's like, they can afford to do that. Why wouldn't you just do it? And then you avoid this.
Yeah, because I don't think they give a shit. It's much like the same reason why they absolutely knew what was happening and they did not have their marketing team or anybody intervene, because they don't really give a shit. I don't know any other reasoning for it other than, like, they don't have the manpower and they don't care.
I guess then she did do one other update.
Wait, who is
that? Okay, I know Hannah? I said that last video was the final update, but I forgot to say that she told me she was at the police station filing a report against me early this morning, and I told her, you don't have to do all that. Like, just come down here and, like, show me where the stuff is. And she was like, I'm not doing shit for you until you clear my name. And I was like, just clear your name by showing me where my things are. And she was like, no, you can come down to the police station and we can sell it this way. Then she told me that she was sending the deputy to my house. I told her that she could give me, like, his contact information. I'd be happy to talk to him. And she said, no, he's coming there. We never did have a deputy show up at our house, but we did have one drive by twice. And so we asked if he was here for, like, the TikTok stuff, like, if it was related to that. And he actually said no. He was here because he heard there was a really cool house in this neighborhood, and he just wanted to look at the house. So, I, like, that, I don't know what else.
I'm dying.
I don't know what else there is. I don't know. I feel like a cop probably wouldn't want anything to do with this issue, because my shit's missing, and I made a video about it in a story.
That's literally, oh, like, my that God. Would not, you wouldn't be like, oh, this person's threatening me online. And they'd be let me see. And then
it, they'd be like, I'm sorry. Oh. I completely called it. She's completely full of shit, obviously. And, like, she was not going to go to any fucking police station.
The deputy's coming there right now. Okay. Like,
I'm just going to say this for anyone that may be watching for this situation and others. You are not responsible for what other random people do that you did not tell them to do and you have no connection to.
And not only that, this is so reminiscent of something. I just can't put my finger on it.
I can't either, yeah.
If you do stupid shit online and people have an issue with that, separate from what the original person calling you out, like, that, uh-huh, they don't correlate, uh-huh, you know, you're doing your own stupid shit on the internet and people don't like it, they're gonna tell you, and those people, those other people, have nothing to fucking do with that, and they don't have to come on the internet and say, please don't say anything mean to that
you
person.
You can't order someone to make a statement. Also, guess what? It doesn't matter. Hannah could be like, everybody leave her alone. People aren't going to leave her alone. Like, that's not going to do anything.
No, absolutely not.
That's not how the internet works.
Absolutely not.
So I think the moral of this story is, play stupid games, win stupid prizes.
Absolutely. I agree with that sentiment. So you would think that the story's done, but apparently it's not, because Hannah then said that she has some information from the alleged homeowners of the house that she says she dropped things off in. And so she started posting a series of, like, Instagram stories explaining all of this with screenshots and proof. So
this screenshot basically shows that someone says that house is about to be on the market.
Oh
my God. Then someone slid into Hannah's DMs and said she stole from us last week in Gulf Shores. We had a large Target order and she said it was delivered and she never delivered. Had to report her up. And yet somehow Instacart are still letting her shop.
Shut the fuck up. Are you kidding?
Oh my God. Someone else says, I just want to say thank you for posting that video about Michaela. I was buying her car from her back in 2021 and she scammed me out of $2,600 and I finally feel validated. I feel like she got her karma and this was deserved. I'm sorry this happened to you. I wish I could warn the entire world about her. I always wonder with stuff like this, is it real? But, like, I believe it.
Oh yeah, tracks.
Oh my God. Someone says, hey, I messaged you on TikTok, but I'm sure your notifications are blowing up right now. I'm not a crazy person making up that I was friends with Michaela. I have pictures showing we hung out. When we would hang out, she would try to make me lie to people and say that she was an RN. Her birth name is Michaela Williams. She claims to have gotten married to her oldest daughter's father, and that's where Michaela Sargent came from. And she claims to have married her current boyfriend, and that's where Michaela Clark comes from. She tried lying to a good friend of mine from middle school, saying she was pregnant and needed $500 for an abortion. But I knew she was lying and caught her in multiple lies, and I told him to block her and not talk to her. She met two guys from TikTok and went to Tuscaloosa to pick them up in her truck and told them she owned two trucks and a condo on the beach, and she was going to give them one of the trucks, blah, blah, blah. All of them were lies. She dropped them off at a hotel, had their wallets, iPads, and all their personal items in the truck, and tried to tell me when I reached out to her that since I was such good friends with them, I could drive them home without their stuff she had. I didn't even know these guys. They reached out to me because they knew I was friends with her. Those two things were the last time I... Okay, so basically... She is just a con artist and a thief.
Oh my God.
Someone else says, girl, I searched Michaela's name on Facebook and apparently she stole drain someone else for $2,000.
Oh my God. So what a journey. Yeah, that is pretty much where we're at. And I don't think Michaela's going to be coming back anytime soon. Again, her account was banned, or I mean, that's what we think. It's not there anymore. And people have re-uploaded her content, but she seemingly disappeared. Allegedly. Okay, Michaela, please don't call my local police department. But I think you stole Hannah's shit. That's just what I think.
It's our opinion.
It's our freaking opinion. It's such bullshit. Like, her showing the receipt. First of all, I know it sounds kind of stupid, but I do think that her not trying to scan the box, like, either harder or ask for the employee is, like,
that's one of the weirdest aspects.
Right? It's, like, the first dead giveaway. It's, like, oh, you're that kind of person. Got it. Oh, my God. My daughter's screaming like a banshee. But anyway, that's pretty much where we're at. I think that it's just a cut and dry case of you scammed and you got caught. And for some reason, you came online and talked about it, and that was really dumb of you.
They always do, though.
I know, right? The dumbest ones are the loudest. But anyway, moving on to someone, a friend of the show, should we call her? She, and I know it's going to sound so mean, but she just irks me. She gets under my skin. Emery.
Well, now you have a reason to be irked.
Okay, period. I love when that happens. Like CCR.
There you go. I mean, I don't think we like voiced that we were irked by her before, but we were.
Oh, yeah. I don't think we did. She just, like, the way she describes stories and stuff does bother me. Like, the way she almost presents things. Does that make sense?
It doesn't. I mean, what I was like, a little put off by was, by the way, we're talking about this girl.
Sorry.
Sorry, we always do that. We're talking about this girl, Emery, who you might remember is the person we covered that she got married to her first boyfriend after 4 months. And she not only did that, but then she decided to, I guess she was what you would call a beauty creator before, but then she made a very, very strong pivot to have all of her content be about, I married my first boyfriend after 4 months. Literally, let me put in a compilation of all of the time she says that, because it's unreal. Like, I couldn't pull an asset without her prefacing it with that.
I'm 27 years old and I have a boyfriend for the first time.
I am marrying a guy that I met 3 months ago. Not only that, he has been my one and only boyfriend. How freaking cool is it that I can just say I married my first boyfriend?
Get ready with me to get engaged to a guy I met 3 months ago.
So I married a guy I met a few months ago. So I got married to a guy I met a few months ago.
I'm getting married to a guy I met a few months ago.
So if you're new to this topic, I married a guy that I didn't know for very long.
I'm getting married to a guy I met a few months ago.
Get ready with me to get married to a guy I met a few months ago.
Getting ready to marry a guy I met a few months ago, part two.
The fact that I had only known my husband now for a few months when we got married.
I will say, though, that was short-lived. I think that once people started, like, clowning her for it almost, like, people were just like, this is bullshit, like, what are you doing? This is gonna end in disaster. She very quickly made the pivot back to beauty content. I don't know if she thought, like, oh, this is my in. Like, this is the way that I'm gonna, like, get into this community.
I don't think it's about her, like, getting shit for it necessarily. I mean, I'm sure she got a lot of it. But I thought it was more like, and I mentioned it last time, that's not sustainable. You're gonna run out of story times after a while. Absolutely. It was like, get ready with me for my wedding. How many times can you really do that? I mean.
Well, and she also, notably, if you didn't watch that episode on her, she did it, like, months delayed. Like, at least 2 months delayed. So then we're all confused of the timeline. None of it makes sense. People got disinterested very, very quickly. So she started.
When she kept posting the same shit over and over again. So,
yeah.
Again,
so she started going back to
I don't think it was sustainable. So she was like, oh, crap. Well, I have this audience now, because I think a lot of people followed her during that. She was like, okay, let me pivot back to do what I was doing. But here's
do people
want to
know how
say.
The internet works? That's no. not how that works. It's the same. I mean, I've said this so many times. It's the same as when people like sell their YouTube channel. It's like, well, we don't want to see this new bitch.
Well, it's like they followed you for a specific content.
Right.
And guess what? If you can't deliver that content anymore,
we don't want
that it. That sucks. They're going to leave. So then when you go, you can't expect that they followed you for beauty content when they followed you just because they wanted the tea on your marriage. And
Correct.
They actually are probably just waiting until it implodes. But just being honest. But then she pivots back to beauty stuff because I think she wants to take advantage of this newfound following that she has.
Right.
But then guess what? she not only isn't going to be able to like keep people hooked with that because that's not what they signed up for, but also because it doesn't seem like she has as many original ideas, you could say.
And also, okay, how must I word this? Please give me a moment. She's not like very good at makeup or hair.
You know, okay. Well, I was just going to focus on the fact that she just didn't have original ideas. But because, for example,
true, but I'm just saying. You know,
I've even said this in our group chat. I produced a beauty show for years.
Right.
Do you think I know anything about beauty? If you're going to say but yes, that's bless a niche, your heart, because I don't. And for a while, I was producing a show that was about beauty that was like, we're supposed to be the experts. And literally, it did horrible because no one wanted to watch it because guess what? You could tell we weren't experts. So then I went to my boss.
That's the thing.
And I was like, hey, no one's watching this and you're making me make it. So like, can I maybe stop lying to people and pretending we know what we're talking about? And instead we just like try stuff and like be honest about
it. And also embrace the fact that you don't know much about beauty. That's the niche. That's the appeal to the show. If you're
and
someone that
blew like, up afterwards.
Exactly. Because if you are trying to pretend you're good at something that people can just see that you're not good at, which is totally fine. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with her being bad at makeup. A lot of people are bad at makeup. It's not a fucking crime.
But that's not really a thing you could fake.
No, when she's here, she's like, literally, one of the things we're going to watch that she stole, she currently had on her lash lift, quote unquote, and she did the most insane just butchering of a lash lift I've ever seen. And instead of just being like, what the fuck am I doing, and like embracing it and being like, am I dumb, like do I actually not know how to do things, she dead ass did a whole review and then was just like, it didn't really work. And it's like, ma'am, you don't know what you're doing.
What the heck did I do wrong? My eyelashes are darker, that's for sure. But they're not curled at all. And I left it on for the most amount of time. I don't know.
Especially in a genre like makeup and beauty, you can't expect that, one, you're bringing something new to the table by doing the same shit everyone else is doing. But also, then if you're not that great at it, like,
dude,
what? There's no payoff. So it's like, at least our payoff was that it was funny that we were fucking up. She's not even making it funny.
You cannot sit here and act like you're fucking Jaclyn Hill and then like your shit is blended like hot diarrhea.
I really wasn't going to go this route and shit on her for her makeup skills. But
no, but it
is noticeable that it's like, okay, that's your niche. Interesting. But then on top of that, if you're not that great at it, and then we find out recently.
I'm dying at the, we were like trying to be nice and then we're like, wait a second. We have some stuff bottled up inside about Emery. We just have to let it out.
I mean, it irks me as like a producer to be like, what do you think people are going to want to watch about that? Like, you need to bring something to the table. And so she, I think, is aware that she doesn't know what to bring to the table. So she's just like, throwing anything out there, it wasn't working. So then she ran out of ideas. I don't know if she ever had any, but then she definitely hits rock bottom because then she starts taking other people's ideas. And that's why we're talking about her today. Also, like, I get that TikTok, a lot of people copy each other. It's hard to come up with original stuff. But again, if you're just yourself, it's going to be at least a little different.
Literally, it's like, okay, you could copy my homework, but change it up so we don't get caught, bitch. Like, what are you doing?
Literally. So this creator, her name's Lauren Meadow. She has almost 30,000 followers, which notably, Emery, our girl, has almost 200,000 at this point. Again, not because of her makeup stuff. It's because of the fucking... She got married after 4 months. Lauren posts this video.
It says, story time, a big creator stole my content.
Let's talk about big creators stealing small creators.
I guess she's more of a generous term.
What just happened to me. So about a month and a half ago, I made this video about the two things I always do when I wear a hat. I used to not like wearing hats because I didn't think I looked cute until I started doing these two things. And I was wearing a hat that day. I felt inspired to share it with my audience. I hadn't seen a video like that. So that's what I did. And the video did pretty well. And a couple days ago, some sweet angel of a TikTok user commented
not
and tagged me in this creator's video.
Not.
This creator made this video a couple days ago. Never seen her before, but she has almost 200,000 followers. And to say that our videos are similar is a bit of an understatement. She essentially just copied my entire video from like the opening line to the wording, verbiage, phrasing, the two tips I used. The two tips I used are nothing groundbreaking. They aren't. And I'm not trying to like gatekeep making videos on this subject, but this was straight up just copying my video, and there's a couple things that bother me about this situation. The first thing is she did not tag me. I think she did that very intentionally because she just copied my video, and I've had some people stitch my video and tag me in their videos when they're trying these things out, and I love that. Like,
just want to interject and say exactly, because that is them doing something that is a little different. It's like, yeah, trying stuff that other people have said. We did that on Beauty Break where it's like, dude, hey, these are a bunch of trends that are not new. No one is saying we invented them, but here's just us trying them. So it's like, if you want to watch us do it, then you can watch the show.
Yeah.
That is not what she did.
And there's also a huge difference between trends and copying someone. Like, trends are a thing on TikTok every single day. People are doing technically the same thing. But even within trends, if you're doing it exactly the way someone else is doing it, that could be seen as copying too. So, like, I feel like there's a clear difference. We don't need to fucking explain this. She knew what she was doing.
No, 100%. Because I bet you Emery was like, well, I can't credit her because then it's just like the same thing. But it's not really, because think of like stylists. Stylists aren't making clothes, but they're pulling from the designers and like things they like. So it's their taste that people pay for. If you're trying a bunch of stuff from different creators and it's maybe creators that other people haven't seen before, so you're like bringing new things to the table, there's still reason to follow you if you're trying a bunch of cool stuff all the time, because maybe the people wouldn't see the stuff you were trying otherwise. That's not what happened here.
See one of my videos and are inspired enough to try doing whatever I did themselves. Like, I think that's the point of TikTok. I think that's so cool and one of my favorite parts about making content. But this was not being inspired by content. The other thing that bugs me is she didn't really add anything to the video. She just straight up copied everything that I said. And after watching the video and kind of realizing what happened, it really just gave me such like an icky feeling. Like, it just felt like she was trying to secretively do this, thinking I would never see her video, which I probably wouldn't have ever seen her video if it wasn't for that random person tagging me in her comments. It just felt like she was trying to take advantage of a small creator. It just felt very calculated and slimy, to the point where I wouldn't be surprised if she's done this in the past or does this regularly. And the main thing that bugs me about this situation, whether you've been creating content for 2 days or 2 months or 2 years or however long you've been creating content, we all started in the same position. We all started with zero followers, not really knowing what we're doing. And the fact that this person who has probably been on TikTok a lot longer than I have is doing that to a small creator just really rubs me the wrong way. It's just slimy and mean. And it's like, I don't understand why.
Because she made a pivot too harsh to follow her marriage and didn't have any content to back it up anymore. And she was drunk on the views,
wanted to keep them coming.
I've tried to message her on TikTok. I've tried to message her on Instagram. I've commented on her videos.
That's wild.
Wow. My video and vice versa. I have not heard from her. I think that's also very intentional. I think she's trying to ignore me and sweep it under the rug. So it's okay to be inspired by videos you see on TikTok. It's naturally going to happen always, but just give credit where credit is due and maybe don't straight up copy a video word for word.
So then we go and we watch the videos and oh my God.
Trigger warning. This is going to display the botched lash lift in it.
Well, first let's watch Lauren's.
Oh, okay.
So Lauren posts this original one on 5/6 and I have to say that afterwards, I tried these and they worked.
Yeah.
Great. No, great video. Sure. I understand why it went viral.
Yeah.
Rather than watch both videos back to back, Jesse just told me that there are compilations, like clip by clip comparisons, because like, again, they aren't super original ideas, but it's the way she does it where it's like, yeah, come on.
I think you don't look good in a hat. I promise you're just putting them on wrong. So if you think you look horrible in a baseball hat, you're wrong. You're just wearing it wrong. Or in a bun, but you can do this if your hair is down, if you're wearing pigtails, like literally.
You can do this with your hair down, your hair up, doesn't matter. I'm gonna do it with my hair down.
So the first thing I always do is make sure my ears are tucked into the hat. Right now, they're not. And I'm just gonna show you for reference. I just think I look a little silly with my ears out. I just feel a little.
The first trick is to make sure your ears are tucked in. So like if I'm going out like this, I don't feel comfy. I feel like I look kind of silly. So,
Humbo. So I always make sure my ears are tucked in. Also always pull hair over it, so you can't really see that my ears are tucked in. Basically, we're trying to just get rid of the tops of our ears.
So get your hair out of the way. Tuck the tops of your ears into the hat. And then if you have your hair down, you just kind of use your hair to cover up the fact that you're hiding your ears.
What are you even doing? Why is she copying and still doing it wrong? First of all, the hat that she's using is diabolical. Where did you get that at? That is unacceptable. But then also, to do it with the lash lift, I mean, what am I supposed to say when I'm looking at this? Come on. That's like a hat that like a bank robber would wear, I feel. Like, what? No, but also, that's any video I've seen of her doing any beauty stuff, she's always in transition.
Right.
She's never, like, done with something. It's always like, oh, I'm finishing this. I'm like, can you maybe spread out the bulk shoots a little bit?
She had to do the lash lift. She had to take it out.
Like, for Beauty Break, for example, we used to have to shoot a bunch in one day. I would plan the episodes so we didn't have, like, fucking glitter brows in the next one.
Our friend of the show, Cece Suarez, literally shoots a ton of videos in one day. And she will, like, get ready in one and then the next one have her makeup done. And you will watch them separate and not know that they're... You know what I mean?
That's the point. Yeah. You plan them out accordingly. So it's like, okay, well, here, this one, we're going to have to take our makeup off. So we don't want to do that first because we're going to have makeup on again. Exactly. So you have to plan it out like so it makes sense. None of hers makes sense.
No, but you were so spot on with the bank robber. Like, absolutely. She's disguising herself from security cameras. She should partner up with the Instacart girl.
That lands right here over on top of your ear. And most likely if you're wearing our ears. Second thing is how I pull out little face framing pieces. Basically, I always try and make sure my face framing pieces are not coming out right here, that they're coming out either on the side or like at the outside of my eyebrows. If I were to have it come out like right here, I just think it looks a little weird. I feel like it makes my hair look greasy, like it's stuck to my forehead, and usually we're trying to hide the greasy hair if I'm wearing a hat. I just kind of fix that so it's tucked in like that, and also by having our hair cover our ears in case something. So if you choose to have any face framing pieces, you want to make sure you don't take them and have them be like right here, which I know is kind of like in your way, but like you want to take the ones that are kind of like near your eyebrow. So it looks more like this. That way you don't have any weird pieces like sticking to your forehead or anything like. Most likely if you're wearing your hat, your hair is either already greasy or it's going to get dirty and gross and greasy because you're going on a hike or something.
I'm crying. Yeah. Do you understand that I'm crying right now?
It's pretty blatantly obvious that that wasn't like a crazy coincidence.
Well, also, it's like, it's one thing to copy. It's another thing to copy and do it so much worse. Like, that's almost more offensive.
The craziest part is that she does show up on my For You page a lot. That's not the craziest part. I mean, it is, but she basically just ignores all the comments. She doesn't have it filtered out. Like, you will go to any of her videos.
Oh, it's every comment.
Yeah, every comment is like, oh, can you show us how to, like, wear a hat? Like, you know, they're just, like, being stupid. And she just ignores it all and just keeps pushing along, which normally I would say would work. But in this scenario, I don't think so.
My problem with it, especially, like, first of all, don't do it. Second of all, I know she didn't do it, but she didn't credit her because she was, like, hoping it would blow up for her, too. But it's like, if you're going to do that, you need to do it better.
TikTok is the easiest place to go viral, in my opinion. And what she could have done in this scenario is just stitch that video. Just been like, oh my God, let me try that out. That is technically going off of the back of someone's idea, but also simultaneously giving them credit and creating engagement for them too. It's a win-win situation. Why did you need to poorly remake this?
She's trying to establish herself as this beauty creator.
Oh, it's clear.
She can't really do that. She can't really do that if like all of her things are just like, maybe if she scattered in some good ones occasionally, but you know.
We're waiting. We're waiting and it may come.
Yeah.
It may come.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, but she is quite insufferable in my opinion. And to copy from a smaller creator, you're just annoying. As I say, her beauty stuff is not great. My lash is literally flying off, but it's because I was crying laughing, okay?
Again, I think she's just got used to getting views and she was like, oh shit, what can I do now? And then she passed this video and she's like, that's easy. I can do that. And it's like, if that's what you have to do to maintain your views, which I don't think it did, by the way.
That's not sustainable.
You figure out, yeah, figure out a new job. Like, this can't be your dream then. Because if you can't even come up with an idea that isn't, like, come on.
And I think she hasn't addressed it because, like, what the fuck do you say? You know what I mean? Like, how are you going to address
that? She would just lie.
Yeah.
She would have to lie.
Oh, my God. It's so embarrassing. But anyway, that's our quick little second subject. I couldn't not cover that because when I saw it, I was like, the biggest eye roll ever. Like, they almost got stuck in my fucking head. Hey guys, so I have no idea at which point in the video this is going to be included, but this is one of those things where if I had to see it, you have to see it as well, because that's how this works, okay? And oh my My gosh. Emery recently posted, and I mean, she has talked about her husband a lot, as we mentioned in this episode, but she has not really showed her husband more than just pictures. Like, he hasn't been in videos with her sitting next to her, them doing challenges or anything like that. So I was really surprised to see this come up on my For You page, where it's him doing a voiceover for her makeup tutorial, which is super common. I actually had my husband do this on my beauty channel. However, you know, his was interesting. For sure.
It is Emery Lane husband right here. We are doing a blind reaction video today for makeup tutorials. You're starting off with a headband. Okay, very cute. Good morning. Man, glue on the eyebrows has to be so uncomfortable to go around with all day. But then again, women will complain about anything, you know? I've seen men do backflips and heels, and yep, I always hear about that. Man, she is good looking, even without the makeup. Okay, busting out the tape. Can I put some wings on those eyes? What are we doing here? I didn't know the Venn diagram of office supplies and makeup was scotch tape, but I digress. Does that not get like all mushy in your eyes when it all wrinkles up in your sockets or whatever? It's supposed to be some high quality makeup. So, you know, I'm really starting to appreciate the tape now. You know, I've been seeing a lot of ladies walk around with these wings that freaking look like they're doing Super Saiyan in the mall or something on a Tuesday. It's like subtle is good. Ooh, that looks really good though. See, I'm actually gonna say, you know, I listen, unpopular opinion with eyebrows, don't brush upwards right here. I mean just straight back, it all goes in a straight line. And also I'm gonna say, you don't need to fill them. Okay, this is more a question of makeup than anything else, but it's like, I think she put three different things under her eyes. And again, do they not make a makeup that's just single coat? Again, I can't say I use a lot of makeup, but you know, you'd think they'd come up with, so, oh, there's number four. Okay, unless they're all doing something different, and then I'll just feel silly. That's fine. Yeah, I always feel bad for women, because it seems like men have the best eyelashes that you'll ever see. Now, they never do them, but if you ever see a dude with, I don't even know what that's called, some eyebrow makeup. I know it's not liner, but when he does his lashes, ooh, it's just one of those hard things in life. You know, women just got thin eyelashes. See, you're putting on lipstick just makes me want to kiss you. So I got the base coat and the gloss. Wow, what an efficient bottle. I don't know what that is. She doesn't smell like anything, so it's not perfume, right? Was that like the finishing move of makeup? Spritz and done. Just throw a little overall gloss, my gloss coat. Just my...
And even though the comments on this were calling her out severely, they were saying, girl, run for the fucking hills. She uploaded another
one. Hi, everybody. Welcome back. I'm Emery Lane. First, we're going to want to tie that hair back. Okay, we're going to get our bottle. We're going to throw all that all over our faces. This is our brand glue. And oh my goodness, does this work so well. Look at those spikes on those eyes. I can shish kebab on my eyebrows. That's how pointy this glue makes it. I'm bringing out the Aztec coins. Oh, it's more makeup. Okay. These will help cover up the bags under my eyes from my husband staying awake so long. Ladies, if you have gamer boyfriends, this works so well. Okay. We have a discount code GAMER69. For all you ladies that are up till 3 a.m. with your gamer boyfriends, hey, you're going to want to go to your dad's filing cabinet and grab his tape. Make sure to take some of the stick off, because if not, you're going to pull those eyelashes right off. Trust me, it's happened to me like 5 times. It's so annoying. Next, you're going to want to pull out your paint palette. Start with over the eyes and work around. If you get this in your eyes, then you're going to look, your eyes are going to swell up and go red. After you work it out on both sides, we're going to pull out our next shade, which is just going to go on the ends. Make sure that the tape is firmly in place. These are going to make your eyes light up so good. You're going to be so hot. All right, next we're going to want to get our Bic pencil, and we're going to draw some of those vixen wings on our eyes. Next, rip those suckers off. Ooh, so annoying. Look at those lines. I'm thinking of getting some of those, some blue paint, blue paint tape, throw under my eyes next time, but scotch works just fine. Next, we're going to work on some eyebrows. Just go ahead and fill those in a little bit. Oh my gosh, look at those. Look so good. Now, sometimes it's hard to work in between the glue, but that's fine. You just do what you can. Make sure they're symmetrical. Girls with unsymmetrical eyebrows are cringe. Next, we're gonna grab our silver gem makeup. And this is gonna go under the eyes.
this is going to help the other two coats do their job with this third coat. Next, this is liquid foundation. You're just going to evenly spread it all over your face. This is going to help cover up any stuff. And then you're going to want to grab a dry brush, which liquid foundation dry brush makes no sense. But that's because I'm a boy. Don't get this in your boyfriend's mouth. No more kissing on the cheek. Then you're going to want to put your finger spa pad on and just get a fourth coat up under those eyes. Grab your 47th brush and dip it in your fifth makeup palette and just put that over the cheeks. Look at those contours just pop. Wow, look at that. Yeah, I don't understand. I think Home Depot should start a makeup brand, because like women do to their faces what men try to do with their homes, where it's like burm 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 burm. At the Home Depot, we get stuff done. We'll get our new eyeliner. This is gonna help the cracks in your foundation. When you buy 27 10-foot studs, we throw in a bottle of foundation for free. Jeez, my goodness, this bottle is gonna make you look like Angelina Jolie out here. Okay, this is basically lip filler, except just with, you know, makeup. It's an illusionary lip filler. Brum, 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 brum. When you buy clear coat at Home Depot, we give you a free bottle of women's clear coat. And that's it. Thanks for going on this makeup journey with me, the expert in makeup and makeup tutorials.
And when I tell you, the comments are eating him up. And also calling them siblings, but I'm not going to entertain that because that's pretty mean. I have to agree with the comments. What an absolute dick. Like, good one, dude. Ha ha ha. Girls wear paint. You could just get paint at Home Depot. You all wear freaking plaster on your face. This is very much giving take a girl swimming on the first date, as if we don't all know that one size setting spray exists. Like, it's just very, very misogynistic and weird and gross and exactly whomst I thought he would be. Yeah, he's kind of icky. What do y'all think? I got the ick for sure. And it doesn't seem like she did, because despite all the comments, not only calling her out for copying content, but also saying, girl, your husband kind of low-key sucks. She just is frolicking along in her marriage, living her best life, being a mom, and, you know, just slaying. Anyway, yeah, sorry about that one. Just had to show you guys. Okay, bye.
Anyway, that's it.
All that to say, I can't wait to see where Emery goes next. Anyway, I did send you my We Love the Internet, which finally is animals. I do have a dog and cat one. Well, technically a dog, cat, and mouse one, because one of you guys tagged me in this, and I shit you not, I loved it so much. I was like, thank you. Okay.
You guys, somebody get the fucking mouse. He's literally not scared of any of you.
They're both just doing nothing. Look at the paws.
What's this?
Are you kidding me? The ma-
Is this for real?
They're staring at it.
I'm gonna just walk away.
Yeah. Yeah. I do have to say, I found this extra funny because my cat is not this cat. That mouse would have been beheaded, like, instantly.
Most cats, yeah. I feel like, are like, that's very rare that, like, unless you, like, maybe, like, introduce them when they were, like, little or something, yeah, and they, like,
they were friends.
Got them confused. They didn't know which was a cat and which was a mouse. No, but dogs, I get, like, dogs are just curious, and usually, sometimes, like, if they kill things, it's more, like, on accident.
Yeah, 100%.
Like, it's not because they're trying to. Cats are, like, I just saw one the other day where it was a pit bull and a rat that were friends, and it was so cute.
Oh, my God. Gosh. Not the rat being bigger than the puppy.
I know.
Oh my God.
It was so cute. They were cuddling. I think the one I saw, though, it showed them like growing up and they were like friends.
Well, I would imagine these would become friends because that's how that works. Like, if you do introduce them young enough,
we have to copyright the music. But oh my God, they're just like friends.
Oh my gosh.
And it's funny because especially with pit bulls, because so many people are like, they're so aggressive, they're gonna kill everything, and it's like,
I know, he's just hanging with a rat. I do think rats are cute. Their tails just freak me out, so when it was like all wrapped around his face, I'm like, ugh. But they are so cute.
Okay, yeah, so anyway,
guys, we have made it to the end of our first episode with new audio. Godspeed that this gets up and that nothing went horribly wrong.
And look at my mouth is cut, not fully, but almost there.
Give us a smile, girl.
It's just a little lopsided.
Ain't nothing wrong with that. But anyway, thank you guys so much if you made it to the end of this wild little episode. We appreciate you. And as always, we hope you have a wonderful weekend. And we will see you on Monday. Bye.
Cheers.